In the first part of this randomizer, we spent an eternity trying to make it through the Fire Temple. Although we emerged victorious and eventually beat the dragon Volvagaia, we learned that the temple was completely pointless and a complete waste of time. There's a heart piece on top of Gerudo Fortress as well, which we can now get thanks to the hover boots. And we are closer to that, so... That is true. Gerudo has 22 and Jabu Jabu has 5. Plus 4 Skulltolas. Okay, we'll start with that then, since we're already an adult. But we gotta get through, Gerudo Fortress first.
Alrighty, now that Persmi has explained what we're going to be doing, I'm going to take a moment to mention that there's a huge flaw with this idea. I'm not exactly going to say what that flaw is, but you can probably guess.
Okay, so we've seen how bad I am at fighting the Stalfos. We're going to see how bad I am at fighting these guys. Please lock onto her.
So, like any local Starbucks, Gerudo's fortress is filled with incredibly angry women. And after getting our cheeks clapped by one of them and successfully breaking out of jail, we make our way to the top of the fortress where our good friend Pierre grants us passage to one of the easier chicks in the game. Do you also not think it's a little strange that they decided to put a fully armed lunatic who single-handedly marched into a literal fortress just to save some random bridge builders in an unguarded cell with a window? You know, now I'm kinda starting to side with the Gerudos on this one. The carpenters must have been doing some really shady things if they were put behind an armed guard and a cell with a lock. Usually, whenever I create a new seed, I usually set Gerudo's fortress as an open area so I can come and go as I please. It's not because I'm terrible at the game, but it's actually because I believe all violence against women is a bad thing. Absolutely that reason. Anyway, now that all the carpenters have freely escaped, somehow, seriously, think about it. How did they even get out? Link can't even take 2 steps in Gerudo's fortress without having to put his hands up in the air. Like, how did these guys just waddle on away? It's just...
Thank you.
Well, now that the script has been stored out long enough and we've freed all of the carpenters, we gain access to... Gerudo's training ground. Remember earlier that I mentioned there was a flaw in the idea? Yeah, that's the flaw. It's randomized.
So I think now's probably a good time to mention the elephant in the room. I'm using we, our, and us quite a lot,
and that's because I like to believe that we are the ones making the mistakes. It was our problem that Gerudo slapped us in the face. Together, we our team, and it's you see where I'm going with this.
I like how we went here with the mindset. Tokens and dungeons are shuffled, yeah. I always shuffle the dungeon ones, not the overworld ones. I like how we went here with the mindset of going to Gerudo's training ground because Gerudo's training ground has more checks, and you know it's randomized, so it's not actually going to be training ground.
Now that I've restored some personal pride by triumphing in a relatively painless rematch against our arch nemesis from part 1, it's time for the real challenge, ghost hunting. So let's take off our regular green hat and change into our ghost hunting one. That will let us cleanse this temple of its current spectral invasion and make our way down into the cellar where Grandma, who is possessed by the spirit of table tennis legend Ma Long, is waiting for us. After barely breaking a sweat, Grandma was then sent to bed without her supper for being off her meds.
Oh no, I'm gonna do it, but I'm not gonna be like, I'm gonna suck at it. That's all I mean. Okay. If you see something suspicious, bomb it. That is today's Nintendo quote.
Now, nobody really likes a bragger, so I was gonna cut this clip out of the video entirely, but I was even impressed by myself here.
my godlike reflexes, my aimbot skills, I just thought it had to be put... Oh, the reward as well. God, don't get me started on the reward. Man. I fucked that up so bad. Come on, dude. Oh, I did it! Never mind. Okay. I thought I was gonna fuck that up.
From this point on, it was like a burning fire out of control. We had no checks to go on. We had no items that were of any use. There were no temples we could really do. So I made the galaxy brain decision to take a stroll through the Lost Woods. And I started off blasting a random tree with some seeds, which allowed me to get a Skulltola token. It was pretty good, because the Skulltola token, that is a skull shape, reminded me of a certain character named the Skull Kid. And the Skull Kid likes a very specific song from this game that I can definitely remember to play note by note,
like
by memory.
It's the most iconic song in the game next to Song of Storms, and I can never remember how to play it.
Well, that was an interesting reward, wasn't it? Anyway, we used this opportunity to seek out the local natives of the forest, the Deku Scrubs. And after they saw my face, something changed. They saw me as a god. They crowded around me. Messiah! Messiah! They called out. And that's where their leader stepped forwards, and he graciously offered me a gift. A gift only worthy of the gods. 1 rupee.
Went to the fridge, saw our jug in there, and I thought, what's in it? Syrup. What syrup? Smell it. Mmm, smells nice. Finger in, lick it. Tastes nice. Lift the jug and drink a bit. Oh, this is good. This is peach syrup. Oh, tinned peach syrup. Cool. What a drink. So I drank the lot.
What's that, serenade? Yeah. going to Shadow, going to Goron City, that's what I'm calling it.
Hey! You were right! Fuck yeah! Alright.
After how many tries I was trying to get this right, he finally got it. Fuck yeah. What are the options? Yeah, it kind of has to be, doesn't it? Because Spirit Temple, I feel at this point, is vanilla. Or this is Spirit Temple. Oh my god! You're on a fucking roll! Dodongo's Cavern is like running into an old friend for the first time in years. You never really know how things are gonna go, but you're hoping for the best outcome. Or, it can go the complete opposite way, and the exchange is an awkward mess between both parties involved, and you don't get invited out to a free lunch and a coffee. Would it be better if I just come back as Adult Link and do this? Because it'll be much faster, won't it? Because I can skip quite a lot if I do that.
But there's definitely going to be no such awkwardness here, right? Right?
I'm sure it can. I'm not going to doubt that wisdom.
Taking on the mantle of the hero of time that we're supposed to be, we successfully cleanse the world of two of Mark Zuckerberg's escaped clones, and after doing so, things started to instantly improve, and I'm sure what's ever coming up in the next few minutes will show exactly that.
I did not know they ate bombs. It makes sense since they're Dodongos, but I did not know they ate bombs.
sorry, did I say improve? Oh no, sorry, I must have mixed up the script here. What I really meant was cry ourselves to sleep, because boy oh boy, it's nothing but downhill treading from here.
I can't. I was thinking if I could, like, hover boots across, but that thing in the way kind of stops me. Every fucking time. Every time. Okay, I do apparently need to use two hands for this. like a safety net to my stupidity, because I can just do stuff like this, and I don't have to worry about fucking up. Right, I'm gonna go this way first, and I'm gonna come back and check out those Deku scrubs just in case. Because I'm not sure if dungeon scrubs are unique, so to speak. I think that's the Zora tunic. Yeah, that's not the right button. Shit. That's either the I can't tell because the Alright. I'll take that, happily. I think that might be the Goron tunic though, because the colour change. Okay, so the plan now is to check out those Deku scrubs. And Ooh! That's pretty good. That's really good. The plan now is to check out the Deku scrubs and re-enter the dungeon so I can go and get that tunic, whatever it is. Oh, right. You just do this. No! It's not the hookshot. I still think that this is the fire tunic, but... Or the Goron tunic even, but hey-ho. Oh no, it is actually the Zora tunic. That's... okay. That's good. So wait, what color is that? Oh, it's like a different shade of green. That's why I was wondering. Huh. Okay. My hope is that this gives me the iron boots, because I think the iron boots are what I really need right now. Originally, I was going to leave Jabu Jabu out of the video, but we did end up finding the Lens of Truth pretty much almost instantly, and I also feel like part 3 of the video wouldn't really make much sense if I didn't include it, because we do eventually come back here. So I'm just going to let this part play out and take the time to thank you if you're still watching the video. And if you're a fan of cows being stuck inside of a giant god whale, how about clicking that subscribe button and you can become a cow stuck inside of me. Where did that chest go? It's there. Ba-ba-ba. Okay, that's decent at least. I've been needing that for a while. At least Haunted Wasteland's nearly accessible now. Okay. How is that cow still alive? Last I checked, cows do still rely on oxygen. Why is its tail coming out of its back?
Please give me cock.
Da-da-da. Nicely done. Do I have the boomerang? I don't have the boomerang, that's why I didn't come in here. Ah! That's a problem. And hopefully the boomerang is in here, where it should be. The standing heart piece, and that's the mirror shield, I think. Oh, fucking god. So it has to be the... There you go. There's your hat trick. Good job. Okay, so this is vanilla. Because there's an ice thingy in the... there's an ice doohickey-majiggy there on thingy, so... For fourth, you're saying that I'll find the irons here. Well, let's find out. Here you are. Every time. It's always one hit. Alright. Let's see. Okay, it's a big chest. I don't know if that means anything.